this video because I've looked on the internet, looked on YouTube, and nobody really has a video on how to change the cables on a Talon, a 10-foot Talon. So I did one, thought I'd make a video on doing the second one. If your Talon's under warranty, call Minn Kota and see if you can get a local shop to repair it for you. But if it's not under warranty, maybe this video will be helpful. Just remember before you work on your Talon to disconnect your battery. Thanks for watching. Try to make it simple. All right. I said I would keep it simple, but it's not really all that simple. This is easy. This is the same thing you would do if you were going to change your spike. You got to drive this pin out, and that's a 2mm set screw you have to take out to take your spike out. My punch isn't quite long enough, so I got an old drill bit. And you want to save this pin. When you buy a new spike, a new pin comes with it. And a new set screw. At the spike, the set screw is what holds that in. The next step is to wedge a screwdriver in here. I don't want to break this plastic, but I need to raise it enough to get that tab out. It's usually pretty flexible. Now we can open this door up. If you're not comfortable lifting this plastic out, this piece, if you break it, it's about $10, and it's got a whole bunch of rivets you have to take out, so you just have to be careful when you pop that tab out of that slot. The other thing you could do is just drill those rivets out. That's just two more pop rivets you're going to have to put in later. This is the reason I didn't send it into Minn Kota, because I'm sure they're not going to warranty this. These four rivets have to come out. I've already taken three out. Cover has to come off. Cap comes off. Already had this open once to get the cable all. This was just a bird nest in here. Now this thing, you have to be careful when you pull this off. There's three little buttons right here that come off real easy, and you'll lose them. This there's a little spot. I'll show you when I put it back together where the spring sits. And then the pulley fits inside there like that. It just floats in there. So the only way to slide everything out is you have to take this pulley out. Next, you have to take the stop out. All right, slide this out. There's these guides in here. This is a floating guide that has two springs. And then there's another one with two springs. When you pull that out, be careful you don't lose those springs. That's gonna try to pop out. And then you have guides on the bottom. They don't have springs. Now this one's gonna have springs. Or the one behind this one. That just comes all the way out. Next step is we have to take out this extension slide. That's the part that the talon goes into. First, you got to take this out. Now this should pull out. There's a spring in there. You gotta take this plastic piece off to get the spring off. Now we can start pulling the cable out. All right, now to get this plate off, there's a rivet here. And this one you have to take out. Next, this roller has to come out. Now these screws have to come out. This one has to come out as well. This one has springs. Or one spring. This roller has to come out too. It'd be nice if you could just tie something on and pull the new cable through, but they don't leave enough room for the this piece to come through between the roller and the housing. So you have to take these rollers out. So this roller has to come out too because of that roll pin. These rollers are all the same. The old cable is out. this cable is still intact, but I'm going to replace it anyway because they come in a set. After you cleaned up all your parts, one thing you want to be sure of is make sure that these tabs fit in here snug, so when you go to pop rivet them back in, they have something to bite onto. I know I bent one of mine up getting the pop rivets out, but they need to fit nice and snug when you go in there so the pop rivet will grab onto them. Then the other thing is make sure that you have all your parts. Make sure you didn't lose anything. You should have those. These set screws I didn't have to take out of these. You don't have to take those out, but you'll need the 4 set screws to go back in. And then these are the springs for the cable tension. These keepers right here for the springs, they come new ones with the new cable, so that you don't need to reuse. There's a lift cable and a lower cable in here. On these cables, there's on the ends, the cable sticks out further on one end than the other. That would be the one that you want to put into the spool because it fits up inside a little hole and it helps lock it in so it can't pop out. So just make sure when you put your cables in, the little pigtail goes on the spool. Another thing, make sure that you have these little metal pickups on here, because that's what tells the Talon when it's all the way up and tells the motor to turn off. Going down, it probably just runs off of amperage. When it senses a drag on the motor, it shuts down somewhere in the computer board. So make sure this piece isn't broken off or damaged, or it's not going to stop when it goes up and snap your cable or damage your spool or motor. I use the battery switch, because the motor runs continuously, to stop the spool so that this is easily accessed, because if you got to work on it down in here, it's going to be hard to get to. All right, stretch the cables out on the floor. The short cable is the cable that retracts or makes the Talon come up, and the long cable extends the Talon. So get your short cable first and make sure the end with the pigtail goes in first. The sensor goes in first. It's got to go in here. Spring. And then this little keeper. This little end of this keeper has to go into that spring. Then the other cable. So this is what you should have with the keeper and the springs. next roller goes in. And a lock clip on this side. Have to get your roller in. Now run the other cable through here. Now another roller. Now line up the two sections, the short cable, which is the retracting cable, the one that's not going around the roller. Run that through here. Make sure that it's between this pin and that rubber bumper. Don't let it be on this side of this pin. Now that's got one spring, it should still have the two holding screws in there. Fits right on this thing. The screws fit in those two holes, kind of locks it in place. While you're holding tension on it, slide it in. Make sure you keep all the cables tight. Now another roller goes in. Make sure the cable's in the center of the roller. Another roller. That's the roller goes between that. The cable goes between the roller and that roll pin. Alright, now it's ready to go into the other housing. Alright, the cable has to come in between here and here. like that. Have to get the cables in there. Make sure this one's around this roller. The one spring and still has the holding screws in it. Stick it in there. Push it down. Get it started. Make sure this cable doesn't get tangled up in there. Next thing is to put these in. And just slide it in until the screw holes line up. Try not to strip them. This is the one that takes the springs. Just push these in. Just push them until the screw holes line up. Next, we'll take the cable, run it down right through here towards the drum. It's time for this roller to go in. Next, we're going to put the talon back in. Going to put this rubber, or put this on first. And put the O-ring on. It's kind of like a bumper. It fits in there like that. Hold on to this cable. Push it in until you hear it stop. It's time for this holding screw. Turn it over. And you want to make sure that you don't screw it in too far to where this protrudes out of the plastic, or else it's going to get jammed up on either side. So that I can go in a little further with that. Probably till the top of that screw head is even with this plastic. Good. All right, next pull this cable in. Make sure it's centered on that roller, then close this door. Now push the O-ring in. Now the sleeve. Now push everything together. Push the talon in as far as you can. End of it in. Bring this cable out. You want to make sure it doesn't hang up on anything. Now this is kind of a tricky part. It's got to be real careful. We're going to lower everything out. I'm going to turn the battery on. Hold on to this thing and make sure everybody's free of that cable, because it's going to pull that cable in and it's going to wind the other one up on this spool. Turn your battery off. All right, next, we're gonna run this cable down through here. All right, I got a tool with a little hook on it, but you can bend a piece of wire or something. Got to make sure that it's on that side of this cable, because it's got to roll up on that spool there. Earlier in the video, when I was taking it apart, there was this piece right here. You can see where that screw head fit on top of that little lug there. And you got this spring that's got to fit in that hole. Slides in that track. The spring goes up inside a hole on that. So that's what it should look like. Thank you. Now the fun part. Take the screw at the factory, I guess it's set at about a half inch of threads showing, but this is a stop. You're gonna have to loosen this so you can push that plunger down, that pulley down enough to get slack in the cable to get it hooked in the spool. The more threads you give it, the further down you can push this to get more slack. Putting this cable on is always the hardest part. I've tried all different combinations of how to wind the cable on there, and so far the best way for me is just to extend it all the way out, and you have to work this cable around, the retracting cable, until you can get it enough slack to put it into its hole. And the other thing I don't like doing, but it's the only way I can do it, is to leave the cable off of this roller, but leave it on this side, because there's a part that comes up here that snaps in, it'll pinch the cable. But after you run it in and out a couple of times, there's enough slack here that you can just take a screwdriver and then pop that cable onto that roller. Like that. I wish somebody would post a video that's done this before, or if there's a better way to do it, but this is my second one, and that's the only way I could get the cable on. But you have to run the talon in and out a couple of times before you pop this cable on here. I guess it just seats the cable on everything. Once you get the cable on, get everything hooked up, run it in and out a couple of times. Alright, now we're ready to do the pop rivets. Let's run it out far enough to get to the right there. Turn your battery off. I couldn't find stainless steel pop rivets anywhere locally, so I had to order some from McMaster Car, or you can order them from Minn Kota. But I got 3/8 by 1/8. 3/8 long. While it's fully extended, I'm going to take this screw in a little bit. It was a half inch of thread showing about. I don't know if it should be really, really tight, so I'm just gonna leave it there. That's a little over a half inch of threads. Battery off again. There's three little buttons that go on the circuit board, need to go back on. The antenna wire for the wireless remote. Three buttons have to fit up inside these holes. After it runs in and out, it'll flatten out. When you go to put this plate back on, it says that it takes, in the Minn Kota parts list, it says that it takes 1/8 inch pop rivet. But I found out, I just went to the hardware store and got a number 8 stainless steel screw, 3/8 long. I just do this, that way if I ever have to take it off again, it's easy. One 1/8 pop rivet won't hold